Hi everyone, welcome to Python learning series for network engineers. In this series we will see how to do FortiGate CLI automation using Python. So this series is going to have total 7 videos. This is the introductory video, and here in this series we will see how to send command to FortiGate device, how to send set of configurations, how to get output, parse it, and how to read certain configuration from CSV file and push it to the FortiGate device. All these details we will see. So throughout this series I'm going to use NetMiko library. So let's have a look into that first. This is the official documentation of NetMiko. Here you can see NetMiko is a module that makes it easier to use Paramiko for network devices. Essentially Paramiko we use for initiating SSH connection to the device, but in Paramiko we need to handle certain things in the backend. So a lot of things we have to do manually for the command execution, the output handling, then terminal length, buffer sizing, everything we have to handle manually. But in NetMiko, it by default supports list of devices, and all these devices NetMiko can identify and execute accordingly. For example, if it is a Cisco device, it can identify whether it is in enable mode, config mode or not. And if you are sending a configuration, this automatically goes to the configuration mode and sends to the device. In that way, you can achieve network automation with minimal lines of code. You can see some examples here, like SSH enable. Then if you give this, it automatically goes to the enable mode. And here for sending the commands, to send the show commands, you can use send command. And if you want to send a list of commands, you can use send config set. Then you can send it from a file, and you can add certain delay, expect output. A lot of options are available, and installation step they have given. You just need to pip install NetMiko. So let's first try installing it. So I'll be using PyCharm for that. Then here, this is the virtual environment I'm using. I have created another video on virtual environment. I'll add that video description here. Now here by default NetMiko won't be installed. You have to install it manually. This has been activated. I'm just moving to my virtual environment. So you can see here, this is the virtual environment name. Here the command what we need to use is pip install NetMiko. So here I have already installed, that's why it is showing like this. And in PyCharm there is one more way you can do. You can go to settings, then project, you can go to Python interpreter, and here you can just click on plus button, and then you can just give NetMiko and install it. I have already installed it, so you can see the status. Now from terminal, if you want to verify whether it is installed, you can just type pip list and you should be able to see the NetMiko here. You can see NetMiko version is 3.4.0 here. So let us go to the GitHub repo of NetMiko. Here you can see this is the latest version as of August 2021. So we'll be using that. And here you will be able to see the platforms supported. We can click here and verify whether FortiGate is supported or not. Here these are regularly tested devices, Arista, Cisco, HP, Juniper and all, and there are experimental devices as well. Here you should be able to see FortiGate. Yeah. And we'll try initiating connection to FortiGate device. I'll be using this device 0.21 for testing this. Now we'll go to PyCharm, and here first we need to import NetMiko. So from NetMiko we can import NetMiko, and first then we need to define the device. If you refer this example here, they have defined a Cisco router. You can see device type Cisco IOS. So for 40 gig device we need to give the device type as Fortinet, and username, password, host, the IP address or the host name, then the port number, by default it will be 22, so we don't have to give that. So let us configure that. I'll call this variable as firewall01, and I'll create a dictionary here. I'll give the IP 0.21, then username admin, then password. This is a password for this device, and I'll give the device type as well. Device type is Fortinet. Now let us go to the example. So you can see here it is SSH equals connect handler. Connect handler, you can use either connect handler or NetMiko, both are same. So we'll verify that now. So if I select this and click on Control B, and you can see here, so alternate naming, either we can use NetMiko, the name NetMiko, or connect handler, both are going to be same. And if you go to the code of this, you should be able to see the supported device type. So here you should be able to see 48 also. Let us verify that. Yeah, you can see here. So the device type should be Fortinet. So let me just close this. These are the internal codes of NetMiko. Now I will call this as netconnect equals, then NetMiko, and I'm passing this dictionary, the device dictionary. So I'll give firewall01. Now what happens is this, once you execute this script, it will initiate connection to FortiGate device, and I'll just give a print statement here, print formatted string. So this is just to make it more intuitive. I'm just adding 20 times hash, and then connecting to the device. And after getting connected, what I'll do, I'll just give connected. Yeah, now here with after connecting we can even see the prompt if you want. It is not mandatory, so I'll just do a print netconnect dot find prompt. So by default it is able to identify the prompt of the device, so that functionality is already there in NetMiko. So we'll just verify that. So let us just try running the script. So there might be a delay while executing this through NetMiko, because it is validating a lot of parameters in the backend while connecting to the device. Like the terminal length and the buffer size, everything it is handling. So with minimal lines of code, you would be able to achieve your network automation. So you can see here, I'm getting the terminal. Now, even we can just switch to the device. So this is the terminal. Now we'll see how to execute a show command. This is not mandatory, so I'll just comment this out. Now to execute a show command, we'll verify from terminal first. Show full config is a command. So we are getting the complete configuration here. So similar to that, I'll just define a variable here. I'll call this as command, and then you show full configuration, and then I'll store the output into full config. Full config equals, then so we need to do netconnect dot send command. So we'll have a look into that. I can click on send command and press Ctrl B in Python. It will take us to the Python code, and you can see here it executes a command on SSH channel. So this usually used for show command. And then I need to pass this particular command. So I'll just pass that. And I'll do a print of this command. Print full config. So let us verify that. So you can see here I have received the complete configuration in terminal. We can store this into a text file and keep this as a backup, or a lot of things we can do. Now we'll see how to send a set of configuration. So I'll comment this out. Now if you need to add an address here, so what we can do, let me just go to the FortiGate firewall. We'll go to policies and objects. Here the address, so we'll go to the address and I'll try creating one object here. So the CLI for that is this. So config firewall address, so the object name is going to be ip_101 and it is going to be an IP address and mask. So let me just copy this, put it into CLI first. I'll just refresh this page. So you can see here it has created ip_101. We'll delete that. We'll try achieving same using Python. So what I can do, I'll take the same config, I'll just call that as config equals, and I'll put it in a list. We need to make this as list, and these are strings which we are going to execute. Now to send configuration, I'll call this as send config equals netconnect dot send config set. We use this method. Let us have a look into that. So this also sends configuration to the channel, but this will be using iterable so it can send iterable objects. So that means it can send a list. So I'll just give this list here. We'll just move this connector to top. I'll do a print of send config here. So let us try running it. So it is connecting to the device. Once connection is successful, it will print connected. Then it will take configuration from this list, and using netmiko's send config set method, it will send configuration to the device and print in the terminal. Yes. So here you can see the commands it executed. So it executed same command, and we can verify that in UI. Yeah, it has created this object. And in the next video, we'll see how to read details from a CSV file and send to the device like this. So the object name is going to be user1, and IP address is going to be this for each user, and we'll send. And after that, we'll see how to assign this to a particular group. For example, so we will create groups, and then we'll create IP address assigned to a particular group using CLI commands. I hope this video was helpful. Thanks for watching. See you in the next video.